वेलकम टू शांत लक्ष्मी आईएएस। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द एमसीक्यूज रिलेटेड टू टुडेज करंट अफेयर्स। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग द यूनेस्को लिस्ट ऑफ इंटेंजिबल कल्चरल हेरिटेज। ओके, दिस इज टेकन फ्रॉम द टुडेज न्यूज़पेपर। यू नो दैट रिसेंटली दुर्गा पूजा ऑफ इंडिया हैज गिवन द टैग ऑफ इंटेंजिबल कल्चरल हेरिटेज बाय द यूनेस्को। ओके, विथ रिगार्ड टू दिस लिस्ट, actually this list is made up of that intangible heritage elements which help the demonstration of diversity of that cultural heritage, and also with the help of this list, by giving the cultural heritage tags to that particular festival or anything, the UNESCO is trying to raise awareness about its importance. Okay, and when the convention for the safeguarding of the intangible cultural heritage came into effect in the year 2008, then this list was established at that time. Okay, and UNESCO maintains three lists under this intangible cultural heritage. Okay, first one is list of intangible cultural heritage in need of urgent safeguarding. The second one is list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity, and the third one is the register of good safeguarding practices. Okay, we come to the question. Correct statements are asked. Okay, the list includes intangible heritage elements that help demonstrate diversity of cultural heritage. Okay, this statement is true. Recently, Durga Puja of India is added to the list. This statement is also true. Okay, and the correct statements are asked. Both one and two are correct. So the answer is C. Okay, whenever this kind of new things if added to this cultural heritage list, or if there if any new good is given the GI tag. Okay, these kind of things we should remember, because these are the important prelims questions. Okay, second question, which of the following statements are incorrect regarding the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs? This is taken from the today's newspaper. Okay, the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs is chaired by the Prime Minister of India. Okay, and the functions of this committee are like to review the economic trends of the country and the problems and prospects, and also give an integrated economic policy framework for the country. Okay, and it also considers the matters regarding the fixation of price of agricultural products, and also reviews the progress of activities related to rural developments. Okay, and this cabinet committee is not a constitutional body. It is an extra constitutional body. It is not a statutory body or not a constitutional body. It is an extra constitutional body. Okay, to come to the question, it is chaired by the finance minister of India. This statement is false, because it is chaired by the prime minister of India. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs is responsible to review the economic trends, problems, prospects, and to give an integrated economic policy framework for the country. This statement is also true. Okay, CCEA is a constitutional body. This statement is false, because it is an extra constitutional body, not a constitutional body. So the incorrect statements are asked. Both 1 and 3 are wrong. So the answer is C. Third question, consider the following statements regarding the Ethiopia. Okay, one, Ethiopia is bordered with Kenya on the south. Two, it shares coastal border with Red Sea. Three, it is a part of the countries which are regarded as Horn of Africa. Okay, this is taken from the today's newspaper. Okay, Ethiopia, actually Ethiopia is a landlocked country, doesn't have any connections with either Red Sea or Gulf of Aden. Okay, or it doesn't have any connections with Indian Ocean. It is a landlocked country with Kenya on the south. Okay, Kenya and Somalia on the south, and it is a part of Horn of Africa. Okay, this is the Horn of Africa, and this country form a part of the Horn of African countries. Okay, and if you come to a question, Ethiopia is bordered with Kenya on the south. Yes, this statement is true. Ethiopia is bordered with Kenya on the south. And it shares coastal border with Red Sea. It is a landlocked country, so this statement is false. It is a part of the countries which are regarded as the Horn of Africa. This statement is true. Okay, Now, seen that it is a part of the countries which are regarded as the Horn of Africa, including Somalia, Ethiopia, Eritrea, Djibouti, okay, all these. So the correct statements are asked. 1 and 3 are correct. 1 and 3 are correct. So the answer is C, okay. Fourth question. Udyam Sakhi portal recently seen in news is related to A. Help women to fight against domestic violence. B. Create awareness among women regarding the employment opportunities. C. Help women to start, build and grow their business. D. None of the above. This is taken from the today's PIB, Udyam Sakhi portal. Actually, this portal is launched in the year 2018, okay? And the intention is to help the women to start, build and grow their businesses, okay? Through this portal, the government is trying to provide information regarding the financial schemes, policies and programs of the MSME enterprises, okay? And the existing women entrepreneurs or the prospective women entrepreneurs, means those who want to establish a business or who are running a business, if they want any information regarding the financial schemes, policies, programs of this Ministry of MSME, then they can visit this portal and get that information. So it is helping the women to start, build and grow their businesses. Okay. And here, option A, help women to fight against domestic violence. This is false. Create awareness among women regarding the employment opportunities. This is also false. Help women to start, build and grow their businesses. This is true. Okay. And the answer is C. Fifth question. Consider the following statements regarding the 6th schedule of Indian Constitution. Okay. This is taken from the today's newspaper. 6th schedule. Okay. Through this schedule, okay, in order to protect the tribal populations and their culture, a little autonomy was given to that area. Okay. And under the 6th schedule, these areas, these tribal population areas will be given little autonomy by forming the Autonomous Development Council. Okay. Under the Articles 244 and Article 275 of the Constitution, these Autonomous Development Councils will be given certain powers to frame laws on land, public health, agriculture and other, okay, and other matters. And these Autonomous Development Councils, the area will be organized and reorganized by the governor. Okay, the governor has the power to organize and reorganize the autonomous districts. And if there are different tribes in an autonomous district, if there are different tribes in a single autonomous district, then again the governor has the power to divide these districts into several autonomous regions. Okay. And in this council, in this Autonomous Development Council, there will be 30 members, out of which 4 will be nominated by the governor and the 26 will be elected on the basis of adult franchise. And currently in India, there are 10 autonomous councils in the states of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. Okay. And this each autonomous region has a separate regional council. And the districts and the district and regional councils, these councils has the power to administer their areas under their jurisdiction. Okay. And they can even make laws on matters like land, forests, canal water, shifting cultivation, village administration, inheritance of property, marriage, divorce, social customs, etc. Okay. But all these laws must require the assent of the governor. This is very important. Okay. All these laws made by the district and regional councils must require the assent of the governor. We come to the question. It's mentioned under Article 244 and Article 275 of the Constitution. Okay, this statement is true. The president has the power to organize and reorganize the autonomous districts. This statement is false because the governor of the state has the power to organize and reorganize the autonomous districts, not the president. Okay. The assent of governor is required for the laws made by the district and regional councils. This statement is true. Okay. So we've seen that the governor's assent is essential. And which of the following statements are true? Correct statements are asked. And 1 and 3 are correct. Okay. 1 and 3 are correct. So the answer is C. 1 and 3. Okay. And That's for today. Thank you. Please like, share, and subscribe.